Okay, what is cryptology? Cryptography is hiding information and mostly bringing it back again. But it is also used in a variety of ways. We use cryptography in pretty much all the areas of security. We use it as a tool in many, many ways. So that is one of the reasons that cryptography is so important, and understanding what it will do, what it won't do, is so important in security, because we just use it all over the place. We use it so many times in networking and communication. We use it to hide information and still allow us to access the information. We use it to verify the information. I mean, the hiding, you know, that's the confidentiality part. But we use it to verify that the information either hasn't changed, or to verify who said what. That's the integrity part of it. We even use it in terms of availability, because if we, for example, encrypt a database, if we are able to do that effectively, then we can make more copies of the database with less risk of the entire database being disclosed. So, we use it in a number of ways in security. And so you need to know how it works, what it'll do, what it won't do. Anyways, cryptography, that's the making ciphers part. Hiding the information, authenticating the information, that's the cryptography part, making the codes. Cryptanalysis is breaking the codes. Now, sometimes you want to break the code to see how strong the code is. Sometimes you want to break the code with a view to making the code stronger. Sometimes you just want to break the code. That's cryptanalysis. Cryptography is making, cryptanalysis is breaking. Do not make the mistake of saying cryptanalysis is to make the system stronger. That's one of the possible outcomes, but it's not the point. You want to break it. That's cryptanalysis. Cryptology is both cryptography and cryptanalysis, doing both. So, cryptology is what we're going to look at here, because we're going to look at how to make codes, how people have made codes, what you need, and we're going to look at different ways of breaking them, and different ways of breaking the different crypto systems, and we'll get into all of this, that we make for our codes. We are, in terms of cryptography, we want to protect sensitive information from disclosure. We want to identify corruption or unauthorized modification of the data we have. And we want, this is not a guarantee. We can do mathematics in terms of how much effort it's going to take, but we cannot ever say this is unbreakable. Somebody says we've got an unbreakable crypto system, they're selling snake oil. That It can't be done. There is always a way to attack the system. What you want to do is make the compromise of the system too expensive in terms of the money, the time, the computing resources that you have to throw at it. Make sure that it's not worth the attacker's time to try and attack that directly. And, you know, by and large, if you do it properly, you can get to that point. It's not unbreakable, but it's going to be good for 20 years, 50 years, 100 years. It's going to take more money than the adversary has, remembering that you may be facing some pretty big adversaries. Those types of things. So, a lot of those issues and areas in regard to cryptography, cryptanalysis, cryptology, and those areas. Now, we're going to, as I say, talk a little bit about the history, because there are certain concepts in what cryptography is, how it works, that the history and how it developed illustrate. So, you know, this is going to be a little bit of history, but it's going to concentrate on the fundamentals, the ideas, the specifics of who did what when. That's not what I'm going to be addressing here. Like I said, there's other references you can get if you're interested in those things.